amazed when I first saw Grace Jones. She was the first to take radical fashion out of its predictable Parisian context and bring it into the music scene, where I had always thought it belonged. The first night watching her at Lame Mush, I already had decided to work with her. That night, she was singing her hit song, I Need a Man, to a room full of shrieking gay Bobby Soxers. The ambiguity of her act was that she herself looked like a man. A man singing, I need a man, to a bunch of men. I could see how the average guy could get a little scared by her physical appearance. It was so powerful. I thought she was great. I photographed her in different positions. I cut her legs apart, lengthened them, turned her body to face the audience. Soon, I found myself living to the very fast rhythm of Grace Jones. We would go out dancing all night. Neglecting my work. An intense, hysterical romance developed between Grace and me. But I ran out of money and realized I had to stop all this bullshit and go back to work. I had this idea of using Grace as the ideal vehicle for my work. She had inspired me. I decided to get involved even deeper, alternating between live shows and flat art. On tour, we used to improvise, thinking of an idea at breakfast and working it out directly on stage. I decided deliberately to mythologize Grace Jones. Black, shiny, muscular people are aerodynamic in design. It was to emphasize this belief that I painted Grace Jones blue. Sure what I fell in love with, Grace or my idea of what Grace should be. For the 2 years following the birth of our son, there was nothing else in my life. Grace let me take her over completely. Then I discovered that what I was making was speeding too far beyond what was there. By the time our one-man show reached the US, I knew I'd lost her.